PWA Progressive Web Apps. Basically, web apps that can be installed as if they were a desktop application. I don't mean an Electron application like, say, Discord. This is a desktop app built with web technologies. It's kind of the opposite of what I'm talking about. What I mean is going to a website like YouTube, for example, and then basically installing that website as if it was an app. Personally, I don't really care for them. I don't really use them. I don't really see that much value in having them. I like my websites to be websites. I like my desktop apps to be desktop apps. I don't want my websites to pretend to be a desktop app. But that's just me. And I know there is a lot of people out there that really, really like PWAs. And there's a browser out there which, you know, didn't exactly support them, that a lot of people were not exactly happy about. These people consider them to be a very important part of the open web, and ever since they started gaining widespread support, absolutely rely on them. And whilst there are varying degrees of support, they do exist across most browsers. Chrome, Safari, Firefox for Android, and then of course things based on Chromium as well. But there's one very important thing missing there. Firefox, on the desktop, which was left by the wayside. Now, it's not like they never tried. Prior to Firefox 85, Mozilla was running a PWA experiment, and for a lot of people, it was going pretty well. And there's a lot of people that, especially looking back at it now, really wish that continued and PWA support actually happened on the desktop. At the time, though, the developers felt like it wasn't really being communicated correctly. They saw a lot of people that were complaining about it, didn't really understand what it was, and didn't really understand how it worked, and ultimately, they ended up pulling the feature with a developer saying this: "The signal I hope we are sending is that PWA support is not coming to desktop Firefox anytime soon." This is the part that a lot of people just stop reading at, but the rest of the quote is also important. At this point, I don't think we would accept patches to improve the features, so I don't think leaving the code in Firefox makes any sort of sense. Basically, even if you wanted to add it, they're not going to accept it unless you want to go and like fork the project, but it's not going to be in upstream Firefox. Speaking as the developer who spent a good deal of time writing most of the code, I am frustrated to see it removed too, but it is the decision that makes sense at this time. And this thread, as you'd expect, sort of spiraled out of control into a health thread with a bunch of comments being hidden because people really wanted this feature. And even though it was still an experiment in Firefox, even though it was far from ready, the people who liked PWAs wanted this to continue to actually bring an important feature that at least they felt was important to Firefox that Firefox was already kind of late to dealing with. But this was not the only place with frustrated users. There were threads over on Reddit: why did Firefox kill PWA support? What happened to PWA support in Firefox? And my personal favorite, a forum thread over on the Mozilla forums, which as it currently stands, is 30 pages long. Now, all hope was not lost. If you wanted to use PWAs with Firefox, there is an extension to do so. Now, why is it an extension and not a feature of the browser? I don't know, because if some extension developer can do it, I sure as hell expect the browser developers can. This is kind of the whole thing with like video game mods, where a video game modder fixes everything wrong with the game on the first day, but the developers with a team of 200 people can't work it out. Now, if you didn't want to use an extension, your other option, which is a thing that a lot of people did, is just either switch to a Chromium-based browser or install a Chromium-based browser solely for the purpose of PWAs and nothing else. So just install them through that and be about your day, which, you know what? Considering you want them to act like a desktop application, that's fine. I know there's a lot of people that don't want anything Chromium-based installed on their system, so I understand that not being a great solution, and just having the singular browser that does the things that a browser should be doing would be nice, but at least it was something. Now, I think the funniest part here is because Mozilla also runs MDN, the primary source for web documentation. We have pages like this. Progressive web apps. How to build them, how to run them, how to make them installable, everything you need to know about progressive web apps. And for the user documentation, there is mention of Firefox here, saying it needs a PWA extension. So we have all of this extensive documentation on how to use them, but the browser made by the company that makes this docs just doesn't support it. That is the case, at least in the past, because now the future looks considerably brighter. Back in mid-2024, this post was made by David Rubino, who, as it says at the bottom of the post here, he is a product manager on Mozilla Firefox. How can Firefox create the best support for web apps on the desktop? But why am I talking about this now if it was made half a year ago? Well, it was recently updated and links to a very interesting comment. So we'll get to that in just a bit. As the Firefox leadership team mentioned the Reddit AMA last week, we're taking a fresh look at Progressive Web Apps, PWAs, which have been a long top request from our Mozilla Connect community. Today, I want to share a concept that aims to address some of this feedback. So again, this is an AMA from back in July last year. As folks are probably aware, we built a prototype desktop PWA some years ago. Unfortunately, we got some negative feedback in user testing, and we didn't have the bandwidth to take another crack at the design, so we shelved it. Since then, we've continued to get requests for this type of capability, but haven't figured out how to build something that meets the needs of power users without creating confusion for other users like the ones we interviewed in the study. Our product team has recently started taking another swing at this with a concept feature called Taskbar Tabs, so you'll probably hear more soon. Back to the main post. Recently, other browsers have implemented or enhanced their approach to PWAs. By recently, it means before Firefox started their experiment, multiple years ago. Yeah. For example, by making it easy to install any website as a web app, even if no PWA manifest is provided, and by running web apps in the same session as normal browser tabs. I was a user of these features, and so when I joined the Firefox product management team last year, I decided to take a fresh look at how Firefox might approach this problem. In this post, you'll see that I don't use the term PWA, and instead stick with the more generic web app. While there are some working definitions for what a PWA is and is not, most of the feedback from the Firefox community are requests for specific capabilities. So when considering what Firefox should do, I'm focusing on how we can offer features that help you get a more app-like experience for any website you choose when you choose. Web apps should appear with their own icons alongside traditional apps, both in places where you launch apps and where running apps are shown. So in your taskbar, in your start menu, things like that. Web apps should remain open until you close them. You should not be able to navigate away from them like you can a web page. It is an application. Even though it was built from a website, it's no longer being treated like a website. Like many mobile apps, desktop apps should be able to handle links to their website in lieu of having them opened in a normal web browser. So I click on a YouTube link and I have the YouTube PWA. It shouldn't open in the YouTube website. It should open in my PWA. It's possible to take the web app concept further than is needed, into the realm of making web apps be as app-like as possible. This can make it seem like you're not using a web browser or a website at all. Some examples of this might be having PWAs be installed and uninstalled using the OS. So on Windows, you'd actually go into the like application uninstall thing, which is excessive, right? Like, yes, it's convenient to have it there as an option, but it certainly shouldn't be the only way to do it. Or in the case of Linux, generating an additional Linux package that's actually installed in your package manager. Yes, you could do it, but it's going way too far with it. Removing all or nearly all of the browser frame. Now, a lot of people would argue that it probably should be doing that, and limiting access to common browser features like bookmark and search. Again, a lot of people are going to argue that doing that is sort of part of the reason why you want to use a PWA. While some of these may turn out to be beneficial, it's not a goal to make it feel like you're not using Firefox. So, what might this experience look like? Moving into and out of web app mode. Each of these have a full section dedicated to them. You should be able to take any tab and move it into web app mode in one step. When you take this action, the tab would be moved into a new app window, maintaining the state of the web page entirely. You could even be watching a video and it won't miss a frame. I really doubt that. That's a claim to make. There would be no setup. Each website will have some preferences associated with it, but the intent will be to have sensible defaults that work for most people, informed by a manifest if the site offers one. So if it's supposed to be used as a PWA, it's gonna have a manifest there that explains, you know, how it should be set up. I have seen some people concerned that it sounds a bit too easy to remove a PWA. You don't want to have a PWA there and then have it just turn back into a tab and the PWA is gone. As a temporary thing, I do think that is a good thing to have, but if you want to remove it, if you want to add it, this should be a very explicit and very clear operation, not something you can accidentally do. Offering a different browser UI for a web app. Web apps are still websites in a web browser, so the goal will be to fully maintain access to features that help you with the website itself, while de-emphasizing features that are about managing multiple websites. For example, no tabs or bookmarks bar by default, but this could be enabled in web app preferences. The main toolbar would be fully enabled, including the address bar and extensions. This actually is really nice to have, especially if it's like a news website and you want a reader extension, for example. A new toolbar section would show the icon of the website prominently, indicating that you're in web app mode for a given site. This section would offer access to settings and controls for the web app. In lieu of the new tab button, there will be buttons to open a new tab in a normal Firefox window or a new instance of the current web app. Perfectly good features. The address bar would not be read-only, offering easy access to Firefox Suggest and the ability to search. Web pages open from here would land in a new tab in a regular Firefox window, so it's sort of bridging that gap. It's got a lot of those browser features, and if you want to keep using a browser from this thing, it would link it together, but it's not supposed to be used as a browser itself. It just provides an easy way to get back to the browser, which personally I like as a feature, but I can understand if you want something to be purely a PWA, purely a desktop app-like experience, why that's not going far enough. I do hope this is very configurable and things like that can be disabled if you want to disable them. Browsing within and between websites. One of the key differences between a normal mode web page and a web app is that you shouldn't be able to navigate away from a web app. To exit a web app, you have to explicitly close it. To accomplish this, each web app would be a single site browser. Navigations within the current website will remain in the app, and navigations outside the current website will open in a normal Firefox window. The exception to this is going to be some login flow stuff and redirections, so the web app feels as much as possible like an app that only opens a browser when opening a truly external page. If you made it so only on the current domain, it would be in that window. There would be a lot of things that break. A lot of login flows go to different domains and yeah. Again, web pages are not really made to be used as an application, so there's some hacks you have to do to kind of make it work. Integrating with the operating system. On Windows, it is straightforward to show web apps separately on the taskbar using differentiated icons to allow them to be pinned, to show them in the start menu, in the alt tab and the Windows Snap experience, and so on. This allows quick access to web apps using the same services used to run or switch between regular apps by leveling up to the taskbar. Websites you leave running and revisit often, you can save time over hunting for them in Firefox. This behavior may be more challenging to implement on macOS and is likely to have some limitations comparatively. You should expect that if we build a prototype, it will begin as a Windows-only feature. Once proven, we would bring it to our other desktop platforms, leveraging the features supported by them. This wouldn't be very difficult to do on Linux, but there is no mention of Linux here, which is, you know, yeah. So, as for the update. This was posted just a couple of days ago. Hello everyone. I spent some time just now reading through the recent activity on this thread, and before I get to more detailed replies to individual posts, I'll say two things. I apologize for letting this conversation languish as I have. I will do better at staying connected to connect going forward. Call it a New Year resolution started in February. I don't know when your New Year starts, but hey, good for you, I guess. A first version of this feature is almost ready for preview in Nightly. I've been on parental leave since December, but I've seen some demos of the progress while I've been out, and it is really close, a couple of weeks, perhaps. So if you really care about PWAs, this seems like in some form, it's going to be coming back in a way where you don't need to use an extension, which... Hey, I kind of would have just liked it if they took the extension and just integrated the extension, but you know what? If they want to go further with it, if they want to build some unique workflow around it, I'm curious to see what they do. As long as people who want to use PWAs in the normal PWA way can go and do so, all of the rest of it is like fun little stuff on the side. Let me know what you think. Are you a PWA enjoyer? Are you happy to see them come back in some form in Firefox? Or were you just using the extension? Did you just have a Chromium browser installed just to go and do so? Or are you not exactly a fan of the way they're approaching it? I would love to know. Now, we won't really know until it's actually available and you can go and play with it, but let me know your thoughts for now down below. So if you liked the video, go like the video. And if you really liked the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe to Liberabe, link in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and Firefox is actually being developed. Wow. Imagine that. Imagine Mozilla working on their browser. Daytime,